You know, I always say on this channel, pay-per-view fights should actually be free. And now the day has come where I'm about to hook you up with an app where you can watch all your pay-per-view events, boxing, UFC, etc., for free. I want to introduce Block TV, the best internet streaming television app out there. They provide over 3,600 channels, including HBO, Cinemax, Showtime, and Starz. They have a massive video on demand library with over 40,000 of the new release movies and the latest TV series. And it also includes DVR. So you're getting all of this for $34.99 a month. And once again, that includes free pay-per-view. So this one right here is a no-brainer, guys, because back in Las Vegas, I was paying damn near $200 a month for my cable. Those days are long gone now. So to get the app, make sure you guys go over to getblocktv.com and put in my promo code and get 30% off your first month. You also get a free month for every friend you refer. The promo code is DB Nation.
Watching Don Cherry Boxing Nation. I want you next, baby. Let's get it on.
Danny Garcia in the house. I'm here to not just say that this might be your next opponent, but I'm announcing that this will be your next opponent. What do you think of that, Errol Spence?
My have tables turned. I've been calling you guys out for a long time. Like I said, tables will turn, and it will be calling me out now, and that's what we're getting right now. But like I told Al Heyman, as soon as I signed with him, I told him, you line them up, I'm going to knock them down.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So Errol Spence and Danny Garcia promoting their fight just did a quick little brief interview with Brian Kenny. And it was only one answer to one of the questions that I thought kind of stood out a little bit. And it's when Brian Kenny asked the question, what separates Errol Spence from Danny Garcia? Basically, why is he going to win this fight? Now, it's not as if this was some great, uncommon question, but once again, it was what Errol Spence said. So Errol Spence, he basically said, with me, I can do it all. You know, I can box, I can bang, I can do a little bit of everything. But when it comes to Danny Garcia, all he can do is really wait around and counterpunch, and that's the difference. Now, of course, Danny, he disagreed with Errol Spence's assessment. He said, not true, because I outbanged the bangers and I outboxed the boxers. He said, I've been in the ring with the hardest punchers, the fastest fighters. I didn't beat them because I was just a better counterpuncher. I beat them because I was the better fighter. Now, listen, guys, a win is a win at the end of the day. But when Danny Garcia says he outbanged the bangers and he outboxed the boxers, it's the complete contrary. Because when he was in the ring with bangers like Brandon Rios, that's when he decided to box. And then he knocked him out with a perfect counterpunch. When he was in the ring with a good boxer like Amir Khan, he was actually getting outboxed, and then he knocked him out with a perfect counterpunch. When he was in the ring with Lucas Matisse, when Lucas Matisse was in his prime, when he was actually the favorite to actually beat Danny Garcia, Matisse was the banger. And that's when Danny Garcia, he decided to box. Now understand this, guys, there's nothing wrong with doing that. Matter of fact, Floyd Mayweather, he said it. He said, you box the banger and you bang the boxer. So there's nothing wrong with Danny Garcia doing this. I just don't understand why he said what he said, because it's not true. Now, what was a good question from Brian Kenny is when he asked Danny Garcia, he said, you've been here before, Danny. Every time you stepped up, pretty much, he didn't say step up, I'm paraphrasing. But basically, he was saying, every time you stepped up in competition at the welterweight division against Keith Thurman, Sean Porter, the fights could have went either way, but you always came up short. And Danny Garcia's excuse put this expression on Errol Spence's face. The image that you guys are looking at right now on the screen, that's how Errol Spence reacted to what Danny Garcia said, his excuse for why he fell short losing those fights to Keith Thurman and Sean Porter. And this was Danny's excuse. I'm gonna play this clip. Check it out, guys.
I would say a lot of that is because I was a lot comfortable where I was at in my life. You know, I was already a two division world champion. Maybe I didn't wake up as much as I should have for them fights, like as far as like grit, like wanting it more. This fight, I feel like this is it for me. Like I'm seasoned now, you know, I've been in a lot of tough fights. I feel good, man. I feel like my career is like where I want it to be, and I feel better than ever.
Okay, guys. So you hear Danny Garcia say, maybe it was this reason. Maybe it was that reason. And then he says he feels more seasoned now. He didn't feel that he was hungry enough, basically. That's what he's saying. But that really doesn't make sense. So you have to understand, boxing is one of the only sports, boxing and MMA, where your testosterone is challenged and it's one-on-one. And it means that that one man was a better fighter than you. That's a hard pill for any man to swallow. That's the reason why 9 times out of 10, you're going to hear someone make this type of excuse. Oh, you know, I had some problems at home. You know, I just wasn't there. That wasn't me. These type of excuses are normal. But notice, when it comes to the NBA, the NFL, you don't usually hear these type of excuses. You know, when they lose, they say we lost and we're going to come back this time. And that's all there is to it, because ego and pride is not so much involved as it is when it comes to boxing. So overall, guys, this is going to be a great fight. Once again, Errol Spence, he made some great points, saying that Danny Garcia's style is to be patient and counterpunch. I wonder if that's going to bait Danny Garcia into basically banging with Errol Spence. I don't think that's going to happen. I think he's still going to be the reserved Danny Garcia, but he's dangerous, though. Danny Garcia is a very dangerous counterpuncher. So this is going to be a great fight, man. I'm really looking forward to it. But I'm going to wrap this video up. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one. Fellas, I've got some great news for you. If you've lost your hair or have a receding hairline, the time has come when you can finally get your hairline back through a process called scalp micropigmentation. So here's how it works. It's a hair tattoo that replicates the look of your hair follicles when you have fully shaved it down. Basically, you will end up with a haircut shape up or an edge up. What they do is they tattoo small dots that look like hair follicles in the areas where you have lost your hair and then blend it with your existing hair. You can even choose what type of hairline you want, hard shape up or soft and natural finish. And to maintain it, all you gotta do is shave your hair every few days, which is something you already were probably doing anyway. So if you wanna get this hookup for my brothers out there in the UK and Europe, make sure you check out The Scalpedist on Instagram. And for my brothers out there in the States, make sure you go ahead and contact my man Scalp Carolinas on Instagram. And when you go on their pages, you can see for yourself what these guys look like before. I mean, these guys are literally hair magicians. I've never seen anything like this before, but all I can tell you guys is this a serious game changer for us men. So make sure you get in contact with Scalpedist and Scalp Carolinas on Instagram. And guys, if you're in the States, mention my name DBN and get $200 off your order.